Folks, well, what I'm going to show you is how to do a sideline hobble. Just using a 6 foot piece of rope right here. If you're a working cowboy, you can't afford the other stuff, well then you could do this in a pinch. Now this rope here is just an old rock climbing rope. You could pick them up from old rock climbers and throw them away or sell them to your dirt cheap. I like to use them as tie strings for cattle. Also like to use them for this type of work. So I know how much you get paid, so this will help you out. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make a middle of the rope clove hitch. So all I'm gonna do is grab the bitter end right here. I'm gonna find a place right here. I'm gonna create a bite. Then I'm gonna create another bite, and all I'm gonna do is lock it through like this, real easy. Like, once again, find middle of the rope, find loop, and all I want to do is go over top each other, not below each other, but over top. And all this is the middle of the rope clove hitch. Then what we're going to do is approach the horse's hind legs, pick it up, and I'm going to tie the clove hitch and put it right over top of the pasture bone, set the leg down. Now what I'm gonna do is just adjust the rope and feed it to right where I need it. Now obviously I'm not doing this to a horse that's struggling. It's already gone through the measures, but then what I do is just tie a bullet. So I'm gonna wrap fingers around my hand, bring a bite through, take my rope, and feed it through. Now what I got is a bowl in here, okay? Now if I got excess right here, I could just ditch it and see how much I got. So what I'm gonna do is just adjust it real quick. And I'm just showing you the mistakes, that way you know how to fix it. So now I can adjust it, come through, adjust it, feed through, draw down. Okay, I got two layers of ropes going around here, so it doesn't burn the pasture bone. Now, once again, for the bowling, I am going to wrap my fingers around, reach through the hole, grab, and create a bite pull through. I'm going to grab the running end of the rope that's going back, pinch it, pull towards the front end of the horse, pull it through, it'll slip right down onto itself. So now I have a bowling knot. You can see it right here. There's loop, there's locking bar. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is simply bring the rear foot forward and set it down. A nice comfortable area. Now right here, all I'm going to do is do another clove hitch. So, make a loop, make another loop. Okay, see how I did that? I just bring it over top. Real simple. Create a loop, go over top. I'm just gonna pick up the front leg. Being stubborn today. Little cowboy trick there. I'm just going to place the clove hitch right over top of the hoof. I'm slowly building it up bigger and bigger, so I'll go right over top of the hoof. And then I'm just going to bring it back down. I'm going to have the horse step. Good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a bowline right here. Bring the foot forward a little bit. Good. Now towards the hind foot, all I'm gonna do is create a bite. Now see how much rope I got here? So I can give myself a little bit of slack. Good. Reach through. Now to go to kicking, okay, you're gonna have to watch your fingers. So I go through, I try to bend and push a loop through without my fingers getting in the way, okay? So I'm gonna feed some more. Now you can see why people always buy their own. Okay, I feed the loop through, see how my fingers aren't caught in there? I don't wanna lose a digit. Now I take my rope here from the, feed it through, create a bite. Now I just feed it, boom, I got a bowline, okay? Now I gotta adjust my bowline to get my rope through so it's tighter. So I just pull it, grab. All I'm doing is making small adjustments. Okay, now I got my bowline here. Okay, roll nice and easy. Good. Okay, now that is sideline hobble. Now what I can do is I track 9/4 and he's good to go. I can take him out to the pasture, a flat terrain, got no obstacles so that he's gonna get caught in. And it's very cheap, takes a little bit longer to set up, but I could do this and let them graze where they're gonna get. So I just wanted to show you the sideline hobble there. Real easy. One of the benefits is it's cheap. You get a rope anywhere. And you got two lines going around so it spreads out on the pasture bone so they're less prone to burn themselves. And it all depends what type of rope. Clearly the cons is going to work. A good tree line rope, yacht rope will work pretty good. That's the type of stuff you want to use. Don't use nylon. Nylon is going to burn them. So there we go. It's just another method for my vaqueros, my vaqueras, my working cowgirls and cowboys, wherever you call yourself. This is the way to get it done if you don't have a whole lot of dinero. Okay, I've been there, done that. I understand. So here's a technique. Hope you like it. Check it out. Okay, I'm approaching, got to the corner here. So first thing I do is pick up the hind leg. Bring it closer to get myself slack to untie this stuff. And the nice thing about bowling, they are easy to come undone. It's easy to knock that locking bar off. Okay, undo the clove hitch. That leg, let it know it's off, go with the hind leg, undo the bowline knot. Undo the clove hitch, middle of the rope clove hitch to be specific. And we are good to go. Walk forward, he knows it's not on there because I gave him a cue by rubbing his leg. That's my cue installed. There you go, folks. Now you got the solution.